Hi everyone, welcome to this presentation. This time we are going to see how to set up a Raspberry Pi microcomputer board. This is the outline of the presentation. We are going to see firstly an introduction, then how to write the operating system on the micro SD card, how to set up all the connections and do the startup of our board, then the basic operating system setup, and finally we will see how to set up a secure shell SSH connection. We are going to use as an example the Raspberry Pi 0W that we can see in this photograph. In this slide we can see the main elements of the Raspberry Pi 0. First of all, we have the processor. Here is a BCM2835. This processor is based on a 1 GHz ARM core with 512 MB RAM. Then we have the slot for the micro SD card here, so we can install here our operating systems and all the programs required for the Raspberry Pi. We have also the mini HDMI video and audio connector here, so we can connect it to our screen. We have a micro USB connector here to connect the different elements of our system, the keyboard, the mouse, the pen drive, and so on. Another micro USB connector for connecting the power supply, 5 volt power supply. Then we have another connector for a camera with a CSI interface. We have also a Wi-Fi and Bluetooth transceiver here. Here we can see the antenna at this point here, which is based on a resonant cavity. And in this area here, we have the general purpose input-output header, in which we can connect our different input and output signals. Finally, we need to know that this is not a microcontroller board. This is a microprocessor board. The difference is that a microprocessor board includes an operating system. So this is much more powerful than a microcontroller board. Usually in a microcontroller board, we only have one program to run in the microprocessor. But here we are running operating systems in which we can have many processes and many programs running together. And usually the operating system in this kind of devices is based on Linux. The first step to set up our Raspberry Pi is to write the operating system in our microSD card. For this, we have different possibilities depending on the operating system that we are going to install in our board. If we are going to use a Raspbian operating system only in console mode, then it would be enough to use a 2 GB micro SD card. If we select the operating system with the basic desktop environment, then we will need a 4 GB micro SD card. And finally, if we want to install the full desktop environment, then we will need a micro SD card with 8 GB or more. So now what we need is to have our SD card, insert the SD card in one adapter. It could be like this one, or we can also use a USB adapter, and then insert the card in our computer. One very easy way to install our operating system in the microSD card is to use the Raspberry Pi imager. So we need to go to this address here and download the Raspberry Pi imager. We can select our favorite operating system and then we run this imager in order to write the operating system in the card. So here we have the imager program running. We only have to choose the operating system that we want to install. The recommended one is a port of Debian with a Raspberry Pi desktop. But we have other possibilities here. We can select also to install operating system without desktop environment, or we can select to install the complete desktop and recommended applications. We also have even other possibilities, other general purpose operating systems, media players, emulation and game operating systems, and other possibilities and utilities. So here we are going to select this one, the recommended operating system, and then we choose the storage. In our case, it's a card of 8 gigabytes, and then write the card. We select yes here because everything that we have in the card is going to be deleted. So we only have to wait until all the process of writing the operating system is finished. Now that we have our micro SD card with the operating system, then we introduce our card into the corresponding slot in the Raspberry Pi board and do the rest of the connections. We connect the monitor into the HDMI connector here. Maybe we need this kind of adapter to connect the cable to the monitor. Then we connect the micro USB adapter if necessary. And we can use also a USB hub in order to have more USB ports available, so we can connect also our keyboard and our USB mouse. And finally, we just plug in our power supply. We require a 5-volt power supply for the Raspberry Pi Zero. The current maximum current is around 1 ampere. So for this, we usually can employ any smartphone battery charger that we can have available. Once the Raspberry Pi finishes starting up, we have our graphic environment here, and the first thing that we have to do is to select a suitable keyboard for our language. So this is the first step. We go to preferences and then select mouse and keyboard settings, and here we can select the keyboard that we need. After that, we can continue with the basic setup of the Raspberry Pi desktop. We can see here the window of the assistant, and this is very easy to perform. Here we go ahead with this assistant and select our country. We can change the password for the Pi user. The default password is Raspberry, and also we need to connect our Raspberry Pi to a Wi-Fi network. And finally, we are going to be invited to update all the software in the Raspberry Pi. And finally, in this video, we are going to see how to establish a secure cell SSH interface, so we are going to be able to connect remotely to our Raspberry Pi. And this is very useful because we can get rid of the keyboard, of the mouse, and the monitor and everything. So if we have our Raspberry Pi connected to a Wi-Fi, then we can work with our Raspberry Pi directly from our personal computer. So for this, we need to first of all to activate the secure shell interface. Okay, and we do this going to preferences, Raspberry Pi configuration, and then configure Raspberry Pi system. We go to the tab corresponding to interfaces, select SSH, and click here to enable the SSH interface. If we are working in console mode, then we can also do all the configuration by executing this command here, sudo raspi-config. And with this, we will open this program in which we can do all the configuration, including the keyboard, the country, and also all the interfacing options and so on. This is very useful in low-cost IoT applications in which we want to use an expensive micro SD card and try to reduce the cost to a minimum. One thing that we need to know before doing the remote connection to our Raspberry Pi is the IP address of our Raspberry. For this, I recommend this program, Nmap, that you can download into your computer from this web address. We can see here a shot of the website, and by clicking here on download, then we can get this program to find out the IP address of our Raspberry. When we execute the program, we will get a screen like this one, in which we can put here our command. So the command that we need to include is this one, nmap-sn, and then here we use the base address of our local area network, /24, and then we will get this information here in which we have the IP address of our different devices. For example, here we have a Raspberry Pi, and this number here is the corresponding IP address for this Raspberry Pi. So now to connect to our Raspberry Pi, we open a command prompt in Windows and enter the command SSH, the username, in this case Pi, and the IP address. And then introduce our password. And we are inside our Raspberry. So we can see, for example, the directory. We can move and see the different folders and so on. Sometimes, especially in the first connection, we can get this message here, warning, remote host identification has changed. And usually this is not a problem. If we are sure that there is no threat issue, then we can delete the offending key from our known host file using this command here. So with this, we should be able to connect to our Raspberry Pi again. Well, this is all for today. Thank you very much for watching this video. Please let me know if you have any comment or question, and see you in the next video. Goodbye now.